You know, we talk about the basketball team a lot. I like to watch the games. You know, we'll have some conversations with me and a buddy of mine about kind of how things are going. You know, I think this team kind of goes as Tevin Mack goes. You know, I know you kind of know what you get from Sims, you know, for the most part every night, you know, and the intention that he kind of draws. But, you know, the streaky shooting of Mack, you know, kind of seems to make or break the team. I mean, do you kind of have any thoughts on that, or kind of have a different analysis, a different outcome?
Well, I think there's without a doubt a difference in the team, the way they perform whenever Mack is playing well. But now, keep in mind, I was pretty preoccupied with Carson. I actually just resigned that position, but I'll give you some more background on that in a minute. But Tevin Mack, when he's playing against Duke, Carolina, and some of these guys, he's much more engaged at doing more than just shooting threes. It's just a significant difference. He plays NC State, and he's chasing. And then he plays the game before he plays Duke, and he's engaged. He's attacking, because I don't know if it's has to do a little bit with the opportunities around the rim or what, but I can definitely see exactly what you're talking about, because whenever he's good, the team's good. And yeah, he's got – I talked to Dick Bender, the assistant coach, about this the other day. If you put Tevin Mack on last year's team, it provides kind of the same spurtability, if you will, spurtability. I like that word for him.
That's a good
spurtability
one.
To be able to kind of pick your team up emotionally. And Gabe DeVoe had it 2 years ago, and last year it was like you didn't really have that extra oomph, because you kind of knew what you were going to get out of Shelton Mitchell. You knew what you were going to get out of Marquise Reed. Eli Thomas was a coin flip. But there was never really anybody to kind of be able to spark and hit four right in a row to kind of give you that energy. And when Tevin Mack isn't chasing threes and he's letting it come to him and he's getting some looks at the basket, he's really good. When he tries to chase, like he did against Louisville, he gets too preoccupied with the three ball, and it affects both sides of the floor for him. And it makes it difficult, really, for guys to kind of get in the groove around him. So I think you're absolutely right.